Good evening, everyone. It's Colette here on Out Late But Great, your host for Tuesdays. I hope you guys are doing great. You had a wonderful weekend and that your week is shaping up to be fabulous. I'm here in my messy kitchen making dinner, and I thought I'd tackle this week's topic, which was Michelle's choice. And she actually chose it from one of our viewers named Jesse Kraft. And the question is, or the topic, having grown up in a very conservative culture and having heard so many false teachings about LGBT people from religious people, what is your personal story about how you overcame beliefs which have been imposed on you? Beliefs that may have caused you to feel unloved by God / higher power and unworthy as a person. Well, I can relate a lot to this topic because I grew up in a very conservative upbringing and I grew up in the Catholic Church. I wouldn't say that how I was raised was necessarily super strict. I wasn't forced to go to Sunday school, but it was really encouraged for me to be an altar boy, which I did for a little bit, and then I quit because I wasn't a boy. At that time, I didn't know, but I wasn't comfortable doing that. And so it was really interesting that when I quit, it was a major upset in my family. They were like, how could you? You know, and I think it's, you know, that side of my family that's Catholic is Mexican. And they always want like a priest in the family, which I find interesting. And, you know, some other background, my mom was a nun for about 10 years before she met my father. And my father wasn't the reason why she left the convent. It's a other long story. But she has a very strong Catholic faith. And I was raised with the same sort of, I guess you could say, faith. And as a kid, I was always really scared, I guess you could say. I was scared of everything. I thought I was going to be possessed by the devil. I was terrified of the bloody Jesus hanging on the cross in the middle of the church. Like, everything terrified me, and there was something always spooky about the Catholic Church. But what was interesting, when I hit puberty and I started to feel different and everyone else noticed that I was different, and, you know, I never really got a sense of relief from school and from my family. I was always mercilessly teased and bullied. So for me, going to church was actually a positive thing. At that point, what I found interesting is like doing the rosary and like praying, was almost kind of like meditative, and listening to music and singing along was like, I felt connected, I guess you could say. And the people at church were always really nice to me. I never got anything like nasty from people. Except we went to one congregation where the priest talked about how homosexuality was wrong. And one of my family members took care of a priest, and they forced me to go to confession. And basically he was reiterating why homosexuality was bad, you know, because I was a very effeminate boy, and I think they just kind of assumed that might straighten me out or something. I don't really know. But that's when I started to sour towards going to church, and kind of soured to a lot of things that had to do with religion, because it was kind of traumatizing. Like, this place that I felt comfortable and safe, I was basically made to feel like, wait a minute, you're accepted here, but if you go this direction, you can basically count your losses. Which was interesting, because one of the churches that I attended in Houston, Texas, where some of my family lives, there was tons of gay couples, and a lot of them were, you know, had HIV and AIDS. And it was strange because, you know, one of my aunts who took care of the priest, they would administer mass and communion to them, and they were really respectful, but it was weird. It's like, but I couldn't be different, if that makes sense. But anyway, and now as an adult, since I've gone through my transition, oh my God, see my big mess of my pantry, just ignore that. I've been trying to figure out what works for me spiritually, because for me, I still have that inclination and still have that Catholic part of me. Like, I kind of like what Michelle said, like, once you're a Catholic, you're kind of always a Catholic. I think for me, though, I'm way more open-minded. I was that way when I was a kid, too. I wasn't closed off. I didn't think that what I believed was the right way or the only way. And as I get older, I'm just more open to other ideas of thoughts and, you know, but there's something about the rituals of Catholic Church that I miss, and being in a group praying with people. And I've gone to Mass a few times since I've transitioned. You know, and part of it's to connect with my mom, since we're kind of estranged, and that's where I feel her presence most of the time. And, but yet there's a part of me that doesn't really feel connected to the church, if that makes sense. Anyway, basically how I overcame it was I realized that if religion is supposed to be freeing in the sense that it's supposed to open your heart, and God, believing in God or higher power, divinity, is supposed to open your heart and feel compassion. So for me, how I overcame it is I think I knew innately at a young age that it didn't really matter what people thought. Like, my faith is my faith. And I really think I got that from my grandmother, my Mexican grandmother, who always said, don't let people deter you from whatever you believe and what your faith is. So for me, I guess I'm a work in progress when it comes to religion, but I don't really feel like oppressed. I now feel a lot freer, and it does take, I think, years of deprogramming what's kind of imposed on you as a kid. And you do feel unworthy and unloved, and that was like a struggle for me, I think, through my teens and my 20s. But now I realize that if there is God, there is divinity, and divinity is love. So for me, it's like, you can say whatever you want, because my connection to whatever I believe, I know is to be true. That makes sense. So I hope that answers the topic. It's kind of it's kind of a difficult topic, because I think spirituality and all that is really, it's very personal. I feel it's a very personal topic, but it's a great topic, and I'm glad Michelle chose this. But I hope you guys have a great rest of your week, and I will check in with you soon. Take care. Bye.